I'm Kathleen Stross, and I'm a vestibular rehab therapist, and I'm a volunteer for the Vestibular Disorders Association. I help my patients with vestibular problems by designing customized, specific exercises directly related to their particular problem. The majority of my patients are seen 3 to 5 times. Some are maintained longer, and that's particularly those who have chronic vestibular problems. I might see them 5 times initially and then do monthly follow-ups. People with vestibular disorders can often find help from home programs. Some are available online, but others will be given to them by a vestibular specialist when their specific diagnosis is learned. But yes, you can find help by doing home exercises to help your dizziness and your balance problem. In my practice, after the first session, I'm able to tell a patient sort of what kind of vestibular problem I think they have and then what it's going to take for them to get better. Some people ask me, if I've had this vertigo, am I always going to have it? Well, that's a yes and no question. There are certain types of vestibular disorders, particularly positional vertigo, that can be cured. A good therapist or a doctor can do particular repositioning maneuvers that actually can cure that type of positional vertigo. And in those cases, I discharge patients and may never see them again. Other diseases and problems with the vestibular system can come and go over time, or some can even be chronic. When I interview patients with vertigo and balance problems, the one thing they want people to know is that they're not stupid. And that's because when you're having to spend brain power to make sure that you feel steady and that you stay in your chair, it can cause cognitive problems and memory problems and distractibility in patients who are suffering. So I have patients all the time say, is this normal that I have memory loss? Is it normal that I can't concentrate or that I'm exhausted after just a few hours of concentrating or focusing on things? And the answer is yes, it is typical that people with vestibular problems suffer a myriad of secondary symptoms that are a result of the fact that their brain is having to really spend extra energy on something that really is supposed to be in the background. VITA and its website at vestibular.org is visited by millions of people every year. And we're able to collect information from people with vestibular disorders and create a giant database that will be accessible to those interested in researching this further. So given that there is scientific research going on in exploring how to better diagnose and treat vestibular disorders, there's also now this patient database and the patient experiences that VITA can serve an integral part in between these two, to bring the scientific research and the patient experience together to overall really be of benefit to those with vertigo and balance disorders.